Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about the TCP segment structure. As we already seen UDP segment structures, now let's we understand TCP segment structure. In TCP segment structures, let's understand individual field. So in TCP segment, it has 32 bit, means 4 byte long. 32 divided by 8 means 4 byte. 16 bit port number and 16 bit destination port number. Here there are few of flag bits. First one is U, urgent data, which is generally not used. Acknowledgment field A, push data, now it is generally not used, but it denote P. Reset, synchronize and finish, so means connection is established or any setup connection. Tear down means connection terminate. Commands we use R, S and F bit. Now the internet checksum, this field is similar as we seen in UDP segment. It is used in checksum method. See, sequence number and acknowledgement number, this is counting in terms of byte, not a segment. And receiving window means, as we seen in earlier protocol, we have views window size. So receiver window size defined by here in terms of bytes. And other variable length options filled. Over here, this is application data, which is variable length. Now, the unit of transmission in TCP, we can say it is a segment. So in application layer to transport layer, we says data as a segment. The header include source and destination port, as we seen in unit 2 application layer. The source and destination port number, which are used in multiplexing and demultiplexing from upper layer applications. The 32-bit sequence number field and 32-bit acknowledgement field are used by TCP sender and receiver to implementing reliable data transfer services. We have used this sequence number field and acknowledgement number field in RDT protocol for reliable data transfer services. Here the sequence number for segment is the byte stream number of first byte of segment. So the in segment, the first byte is used for the sequence number, and acknowledgement number is a sequence number of next byte. Host is expecting from the another host. Here, the 4-bit header length field specify the length of TCP header in 32-bit word. So in this field, it is stored total length of the TCP header. The TCP header can be variable length due to the optional field of TCP segment. The 16-bit receiving window, which is used for flow control, means packet receiving capacity at receiving side. So it is used to indicate number of bytes that receiver is willing to accept from sender side. The 16-bit checksum field is used for the error checking of header and data, which we have seen in earlier video. Now, the unused 6-bit are reserved for future use and should be sent to as a 0. In urgent pointer, it is used in combining with urgent control bits for the priority of data transfer. This field contains sequence number of last byte of urgent data. Let us see few of 1-bit field of TCP segment. Data, which is application message in terms of byte, which will being sent in a segment. Here the URG 1-bit field indicate that the urgent pointer field, which is significant. Acknowledgement bit, it is 1-bit, and that indicate the acknowledgement field, which is significant. The push function ask to push buffer data to receiving application. It use 1-bit. RST reset the connection and it is used 1 bit. Synchronize connection. For the synchronized sequence number, only the first packet sent from each end should have this flag set. Some other flag and fields change meaning based on this flag. And some are only valid for when it is set and other when it is clear. So synchronization is used for the synchronizing sequence numbers. And FIN 1 bit. So means the connection terminate. So no more data from sending side. So it is used 1 bit. The TCP segment is used for the data transferring from upper layer to down layer. These are the field value which useful in reliable data transfer, flow control and other synchronizing transmission. In next video, we will discuss about the flow control and congestion control. Thank you.